model, didn't you? Okay. You talked a bit about seasoning, the branding process, yeah, the slave shirt. Resistance and rebellion, okay? So how enslaved people resisted their life of enslavement, okay? And to sum up these emotions here, okay? Loss and fear, okay? So why do you think they might be relevant to what we're talking about? What about loss? Yeah, so there'd be, absolutely. Okay, so who is going to work on the still images? Who's going to volunteer to take the cameras? I know you've got cameras of your own, but we've got museum cameras here. So we've got one there. So if we can have two on still images. You want to...
do the loss and the popular one.
Okay, well, if you can perhaps a group of two, and if you can collect these images, yeah?
Can we all just gather, though? Because I'm going to work with a group doing still images. So what's your name?
Josh.
Calvin and Mr. Eckersley. Okay, so if you three can join me on this table, and I'm going to get started. Okay, can we all go to this table and start talking?
What are you holding in your hand?
Polishing column.
What does it do? It
stops living from the mouth.
What is it made out of?
No.
My name's Callum, I'm in the Slavery Museum in Liverpool with my colleague Fred. And could you tell me what you're holding there?
Yes, it's a branding iron.
What did they use it for?
The slave master would use it to enslave an African as a life of property.
Would it have been made on the ship?
It may have been made by a blacksmith on the ship, yeah.
Does it leave a mark or a scar?
Yeah, it would.
Or any infection?
It would leave a mark. On the shoulder, on the back of the shoulder, or on the front, on the collarbone.
So for every photo, get one photo, and then every photo you take,
we'd like
it to have.
And
what are the words really in that sentence?
Mm. All right.
So
like, it's not like you've got these guys talking. Excellent. Talk about it in background.
My name's Richard and I'm with my friend Bob at the Liverpool Slave Museum. We are reading some lines from the life of Ekuano. The first object that I saluted in my eyes I arrived on the course was the sea and the slave ship which was riding in the anchor waiting for its cargo.
I became sick and low that I was not able to eat. Now I wish for the last friend of death to relieve me.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Hi, my name's Esley. I'm reading off the life of Gustav Vasa. When I looked round the ship too, I saw a large furnace or copper boiling and a multitude of black people of every description chained together. I no longer doubted, I felt motionless on the deck and fainted. Thank you.